Well, welcome. It's time for another episode of Control. So we were going to the Prime Candidates program. I think that was the plan. Yeah, I guess. I've got a new outfit. Let's see. There we have to go. So let's see what the horrible things lies beyond. That way. Oh yeah, we can fly. Do that. Shit. This way. Excellent. Definitely didn't expect him there. But he did. Can't go this way. Alright, where's that freaking orb thing? He did. With some warp shit right here. You are the sun, folks. The sun is long. let's see what's over here. I think. Where are we? Oh, there we are. Well, let's finish upstairs first. More on this side, maybe. All right, weird warpy bendy, but did TV also do this? Maybe it did. There's a door we can go through. Closed cases. P6. That's Dylan. P7. Oh. What's down? Loot. Nice. Ah, this is where I entered, so excellent. Go closed cases first. Don't let mold hit you right. One more step later, with better visuals.
I wish things had gone differently in ordinary for us. But wishing won't change things. Finding the projector will.
Ordinary. There's so much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy, Dylan Faden, prime candidate 6. And the sister as well. Once we catch up with her, but the boy, so much potential. We're talking right. Northmore level readings here.
Well, what you like?
Is this what Dylan wanted me to see? It doesn't matter. We need to find that projector. All of the times I felt paranoid, I was right. The Bureau could have given me the answers, but they just stood by and watched me.
Shoplifting. Oh, candidate P7 outfit.
We used to play there all the time. Me and Dylan. And other kids as well. We loved it. This time, I remember was different. We found a way in, deeper into it, like it had shifted. We went inside and that's where we found the slide projector.
A dump is a place for lost things that have been thrown away. Did you ever feel that way when you were growing up, Jesse?
What?
No.
Yes, but that has nothing to do with...
Was there a slide projector at your home when you were small?
No.
Those were before your time, I suppose.
But your family did look at photos together, maybe. In one form or the other?
Maybe.
When was this? Can you remember? At parties? Barbecues? How did it make you feel? Did your parents ever show pictures that embarrassed you? Was alcohol ever involved at these parties? Did your parents drink? Did that make you uncomfortable?
No! That's just stupid. Come on! That has nothing to do with this. Nothing.
This light projector, let me ask you this. As a child, did you ever fantasize about worlds inside pictures? Inside a painting? You know, stepping into a painting, into a hidden world, escaping and finding adventure there, away from your parents.
I don't think so. I don't remember. Maybe. I don't know.
Got some collectibles. Imaginary female trouble. What can that be?
We used to...
Ordinary. So much coming together in this one case. A new object of power, something we have not seen before. I mean, coming from me, that's saying something. And the boy... Dylan Faden, prime candidate 6. And the sister as well, once we catch up with her. But the boy, had so much potential. We're talking Northmore level readings here. And I don't want to invoke his name, but it's completely different circumstances here. It's remarkable. There was an incident. Yes. Mm-hmm. lost a valuable member of our team, yes. Excessive force. Dylan has so much. But he's just a kid. I'll take the blame. He needs some slack. I mean, boys will be boys. He's exceptional and under a lot of stress. Roberts got killed. It's an unfortunate accident, that's all. Marshall needs to realize this. We will make this work. We'll make this work.
Stepping to the FBC.
I can see you're upset, Meg. Why don't you tell Uncle Mr. Bones what's wrong?
I did bad on my clairvoyance test.
You can't ace every test, Meg. You see, everyone has different brains. Some brains can talk to each other. We call this ESP.
ESP?
No interruptions!
Some brains can lift objects like a baseball. Talk about a fly ball, eh, Meg?
No interruptions!
So who cares if you fail your clairvoyance test? Maybe your brain can throw baseballs, or talk to dead people, or make friends blind. Once we know what your brains can do, we'll know what job to give you. And if your brains are just right, you'll get to sit in the big chair.
Big chair. Everyone's dream.
What if I don't want the big chair?
Harris.
What if I don't want the big chair?
Everyone wants the big chair, Meg!
That's why we're all here. Use those brains to listen for once, or the only chair you'll get in is the one with straps.
After North Moore stepped down, I doubled every effort to find new prime candidates. There was no one. No one but me. That wasn't good enough. I pushed hard. I never wanted the Bureau to end up in that situation again. The Bureau needs a director. Always. When my time reaches an end, I want more options on the table. P1 through P5 were all false leads, dead ends, and disappointments. Then P6, Dylan Faden. He fell into our arms. No parents, they're gone, casualties of an AWE. The boy has exceptional talent. The oldest house will be his home. We'll build him from the ground up. He'll be trained and taken care of. Darling can be in charge of this project. I can't. I'll stay away. I will not fail the boy like I failed my own family. My daughter and my wife. We weren't careful enough back then. Something came home with me. I took work home. My Susanna got sick. When I realized my mistake, I wanted to bring her here for Darling to do civilian doctors treated our daughter. But they didn't have a clue. She died. Kate left me. Same old story. That was a long time ago. The Bureau is all I have now. And the prime candidates are our future. There are two. P6 and P7. We're spoiled for choice.
I studied what happened in Ordinary here. That's the place to start looking.
Okay. Two candidates, eh? The ultimate test of battling each other. Like I said, I always expect something coming out the door. Out the lifts, elevators, things. Alright. Let's go down. Yes.
Experiments.
Yes. And now it's a test. Who will survive? Your soul belongs to me. Cleanse this place. Much better. What? New York City subway?
We're going back home. Of course we are. It started there, and it's never gone away.
Oh. Wait, did things around me start to float when I came in? Nah. One ability point. And nothing. Alright, so... mold. Nothing interesting. So... I need to go... Oh. Just fail to notice this big doorway. Wait, I can.
Gotta be a way to rotate these tracks. Maybe there's a control panel nearby.
Let's see. Bridge operator. Smooth operator.
There's gotta be a way to rotate these tracks.
Yeah.
Maybe there's a control panel nearby.
You already told me.
Something's blocking it. It won't rotate.
Again?
Something's blocking it.
That's the way, I like it. Nothing. No loot. No. No nothing. No enemies yet. Like I said, yet. What the hell was that? His moth? Or something? Looked like a moth. But... never liked that picture. Loot! Supplies. Get there. I don't know. A weird looking plane. Huh. More like a flying submarine. But then again, aren't all planes practically flying submarines? No way through, so... emergency phone, push to talk. Oh, I just really love this the launch ability. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Airplane evaluation. Yeah, the order. Maybe I should check out my loadout. I think I'm getting full. Right, so we have this. We have a 16%. It's 22. Excellent. So get rid of the other ones. Alright, so type no shield strength. No, I want something else. Maybe energy. Yeah, I think I would like more energy. There we go. So it's a lot of additional damage, but reduce ammo costs and just increase your damage. Damage while aiming.
To America Overnight, celebrating 29 years, shining a light in the shadows.
I hear a lot of activity.
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces.
This is something else. Something nobody talks
in the form of.
Annual evaluation of Dane Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Tango. The questions asked here correspond to the fifth iteration.
Right,
of the psychological assessment.
New control point. Upgrade this. That's it. And let's. I just put everything away. Oh well. Let's do the collectibles again. Chocolate tights.
annual evaluation of Dylan Faden, formerly P6, performed by Dr. Carla Vaughn. The questions asked here correspond to the fifth iteration of the Gunner's psychological assessment. Are you ready, Dylan? Let's begin then. In a single word, describe the world around you.
Where's Casper?
Dr. Darling is out of the building today.
He's never out. He didn't want to come, did he? He never visits, not since Roberts. Tell Darling it wasn't my fault. I couldn't control it yet, but I can now. I learned. Will you tell him?
In a single word, describe the world around you.
A prison. A cold, empty prison. Not even a poster on the wall.
Mm-hmm. What is the next number in the sequence 3, 6, 9, 12, 15?
18.
What day is it today?
How the hell would I know? It's not like you give me a calendar.
You find a rabbit in the woods. It is breathing, but not moving. You cannot see any blood. What do you do?
Leave it.
Expand on that.
It doesn't matter. The rabbit's not real. None of it's real.
What day is it today?
Do you enjoy asking people questions that can't be answered? Is this what gets you up in the morning? What you dreamed of doing as a scared, stupid little girl?
Can you describe a dog to me?
In Ordinary, we had a friend. Nosebleed Neil. And when it all went crazy, you know what I mean. Nosebleed Neil turned into a dog. Or something like a dog.
What day is it tomorrow?
Fuck off! I don't know! There is no calendar! How can I fucking know?
Dylan, calm down.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck Casper! Hey! Are you watching this, you old fuck? Did you send your bitch because you're too scared of me? Where is Casper?
Security, get a team in here. I need...
There is a curious correlation with the yet unknowable forces intruding upon our world in the form of altered world events. These forces gravitate toward archetypal objects, a gun, a television, a supposedly haunted house. So clearly humanity affects this process. Our collective unconscious is a map of sorts. We hold the key, but we don't know how to use it. We create these archetypes through everyday life. Popular culture, urban legends, but we are observing and influencing a complicated system in action. We can change the likelihood of something being a receptacle for these forces just by thinking about it. But we haven't found a method to control the outcome. And yet, there is something unique in us, in our dreams, in the conceptual reality with power, with our minds. What's the cause, and what's the effect? Are we the starting point, or just a necessary evil in this? A byproduct, a reflection, a projection? We'll struggle to find the answers to these hard questions, or die trying.
You're listening to America Overnight, celebrating 29 years, shining a light in the shadows. For staying with us, here's our first caller.
Hi. What I'm about to tell you, if they found out, I don't know what would happen.
If who found out, brother?
The men in the suits. They told me it was an industrial accident, but this is something else. Something nobody talks about. Ordinary.
This certainly doesn't sound very ordinary, caller.
No, not ordinary. Ordinary. It's a town. And it wasn't an industrial accident. I mean, that's what they said. But that's bullshit.
Whoa, please watch the language, caller. It may be 2 a.m., but we're still a family show.
I'm sorry. It's just my brother lived there. They said the town was destroyed, but it wasn't. I went there. The people are gone, but the town's there. It's still there.
So the population of an entire town disappears, yet the town remains. Tell me, was the phrase, "there is no salvation," written anywhere?
I'm not sure.
The same thing happened in Brazil in 23, a village called Hor Verde. More than 600 people just up and left. The government said they were fleeing guerrilla forces, but we know the truth. A mass abduction, as predicted by my regular guest, Dr. Quincy Reagan.
Abduction? You mean aliens? That's bullshit! I know they're lying!
Now I warned you about the language, caller. I'm afraid we're gonna have to cut you off. And good timing, too. It's time for a short break. Hang in there. America Overnight will be right back.
Conspiracy theory hotline. All right.
The woods, the dump.
Sounds like a battle to me. What's this? Stage 3.
Slide projector in the dump outside town. Did they recreate that too? Is that where they keep it?
A poem last time we talked. By Thomas Zane?
Yes. Beyond the shadow of the tower, there is a moon illuminated.
I looked the poem up. Only I couldn't find any poet by that name. I did find a European filmmaker who moved here in the 60s, named Thomas Zane.
What?
I don't...
No matter.
It suits you very well. The poem, how you see things. Maybe you wrote it yourself?
I didn't.
No matter. You've said a few times that you feel like there's a piece of you missing. Can we talk about that?
Okay. Nope.
Yeah, it's this. I feel an emptiness, a yearning for something that I think I lost.
It's natural for you to feel that way. Your brother and your parents are dead.
No. No. Dylan's not dead. And that's not even it.
You're referring to the imaginary friend from your childhood?
Polaris. She's come back. After a long time, she's calling me. In a dream I saw, she showed me things.
Jesse.
It felt more real than anything. As real as what happened in Ordinary.
The industrial accident in your hometown? That you believe Polaris caused?
No, it wasn't an accident. There was no industrial accident, and Polaris didn't cause it. She saved me and Dylan.
Jesse.
No! It was a cover-up. The government knows about it. There were agents there. Agents from... I don't know exactly, but they took Dylan. They... I'll find them. I won't stop looking. Polaris wants me to go to New York. There's a building there. I have to leave soon. I have to be there at a very specific time. Something hugely important is going to happen.
Jesse, you know we can't let you go until you're well. And that begins by understanding what's real and what's imagined.
Poor Jesse. She will never be the same again. How can you explain things like this to people who haven't experienced it themselves?
They moved the whole landfill here in the middle of New York, and nobody saw a thing. Pretty unbelievable. We should check that lab.
That was easy. It's a good thing those suicide bombers can't get up here. So nothing else, it seems. Let's enter the lab. And look what's on the slab. Oh, unskippable.
Effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
Darling took the projector to the research sector. He dedicated a whole area to it, so he knew it was important. Dimensional research. That's where we go next.
Face of the enemy. More zoom, sure. No. Nope. Where's this? The panopticon, sealed threshold, hall, and medical wing. And the other one was Atlas Chamber, Blackrock Processing Ventilation, Blackrock Quarry, coolant pumps, and energy converters.
You mentioned a poem.
Dylan's a lost cause. I know I struggled to see this, but we've contained him now. I wish I had sided with Marshall back when it's just one person. So many dead. I thought his youth was an asset. I just too much too soon.
One B7.
effective immediately. I'm setting up a new department. Dimensional research in the research sector. Transferring the slide projector there. That's where my focus will be now. The ordinary site remains as is. We'll be back to... I don't know when.
The board has been corrupted. Time to destroy the board. Back here now. Get more energy. Yes. Let's faster here. So we have to get to the research sector. That is the maze, the dimensional, the ashtray maze. Ah, lovely.
I need the containment protocols for every altered item or object. Man, I never thought I'd be working in the executive sector. Look at me now, Ma.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
All right. Well, there were also some other things. Let's go do the... this pentacle medical wing shield threshold hall. So that's pentacle. Panopticon. Where's the shield? Shield threshold. Well, let's just go to the dimensional thing. That's where the ashtray maze is, I think. I think there's the dimensional research sector. Has to be. Finnish Tango. No, not here. Excellent. Yeah, yeah. Finish that. This was there before. At the janitor's office. Where was the janitor's office? In maintenance. Ventilation. Gatti. You go fix the maze, Berkele.
I should find the others.
Oh, already killed it. Nice.
There's no Ati. Where is he?
Now this boy left, said the son of Annikki Tähti. My assistant will keep Berg in the glove and the house standing. Lomille lumps, holiday humps.
How can anyone even get out of here while the building's sealed? Let alone go on a holiday.
But Ati actually is the old house. Oh, there we go.
Yum, yum,
gotten in here too? All right. Let's get cleaning, she said.
Kolmesta kahdeksaan, ajoittain noin 10 metriä sekunnissa. Illalla tuuli heikki. Mutuista, hyvä näkymys. Tällainen länsiosa, Pohjois-Itämeri, etelän ja lounaan välillä.
Jännä tarkki. Looks like Black Rock. Yeah. All right. Get to the other side. Thank you. Wait, sent in the quarry, not a ranger. Maybe. Restricted area, huh? Ati, where are you? I need to find the generator boss. Was it? So that was it, right? So slow, so fast, so slow.
I
area in front of this electric panel must be kept clear for 36 inches regulations.
Do you see it?
It is Ati. Nice.
Hey, girl. For a Finn, holiday is holy.
Perkele.
Ati?
Did you miss me? Did you have peace in your sock?
Yes.
No. Bark, don't make a wound. You did good. Take my cassette player. You can borrow it. The song is a present from my friends to you. It will get you through the maze so you can do your job.
Hmm.
Did that really just happen?
Ati is full of surprises. That player.
It'll get me through the maze, huh? The janitor always has the keys.
More energy. All right, so research, central research. So now you can get through the maze. This way.
Plants. Small calculator. Strong suit. At least they can't get back.
Let's heal up. Wait, there's a one of the missions. Talk to the plants is here. Yes. Containment sector, medical wing, coolant pumps. So which plants are we talking about?
I hope your day has been productive. Little
really works, huh?
We're the plant whisperers now.
I hope those nasty hiss haven't been bothering you too much.
Nice. More plants here.
I wish my leaves were as pretty as yours.
You don't even have leaves. Stop being stupid. No plants in here. I think I have to go up for more plants. Ah, here. In the dark.
Do you have a family? I have a brother. I miss him a lot.
Any plans? Nope. More plans.
They say I'm the director, but what does that mean? I have no experience in leadership roles. I have no on-the-job training.
One more. Ah.
Your chlorophyll really brings out the green in my leaves.
Wrong buttons. Where is it? Stupid invisible muff thing.
Thank you.
That's one tough cookie. Is there a control point nearby? No. Not that I remember. Maybe. Yeah, right. And we had a fast travel thing to the maze, so. More energy. Instead I danced with death in fervent skin. If only I could save you from the pain. This is so confusing. nice. That was awesome. It really was awesome.
That was awesome.
Exactly.
The expedition into Slidescape 36. What Darling brought back changed everything.
I hope that song isn't copyrighted. Otherwise, I have to mute the whole thing. Low Miller Lumps, Hollywood, Holiday Humps. I think it was the best part of the game. Yeah. Oh, I want to play it again.
We used the slide projector. I led the expeditions into Slidescape 36. They told me not to go. The director should not put himself in danger. I told them to fuck off. I've seen action before, and I had to witness this myself. To find some meaning in all of this. I couldn't sit on my ass, alone with my thoughts, my memories, anything but that. Those who survived were deeply affected by what we found there, by what Darling brought back. It changed everything. Whether that's a good thing or a bad thing remains to be seen. But I did find my meaning in that desert. A sound, like a needle drilling in, cutting through the containment suit, reverberating on the base of my skull. My whole being. Darling said it was nothing. But he was wrong. It's been there ever since, growing into a certainty, into an understanding. What's at stake here, what kind of a threat we're facing, and what must be done to stop it.
Finding the projector was how this all began. What started in ordinary ends here. You, me, Dylan. We've all come full circle.
Weird stuff. still play a little bit. I have to go to work soon. So let's see how far we can go.
There was a doorway here. To where Dylan and I went, where the projector took us, where we met you. The bureau opened the same door here, but there's just an echo now.
Looks like this.
Just on the other side?
Not high enough. Loot.
The projector's not here. Moved again. What did Darling do with it? I've got to find out.
The projected image from each slide is a physical portal into another dimension.
Hadron Resonance Lab. Broken.
Expedition 3, we located the source of the resonance in Slidescape 36. It is an entity, a living organism of a considerable mass. I've named it Hedron based on its physical shape.
Hedron?
We built a
container for it. Was that you? Did he bring you here? Is that why you brought me here? You're here. You're here. They have you. I know you. I remember her from Ordinary. I thought I'd never see you again. Hang on, I'm coming.
I don't think that was a good idea.
Hi. I made it.
You are to the hole and you have always been the only child of
a mistake.
Trying to corrupt Polaris, eh? Exactly what Dylan wanted. Things.
Get the fuck away.
How far back do I go? All the way? Quite a way, I think. Ah, serious? Oh, all the way. Well, then, next time we're gonna cleanse the siphons. Maybe finish the game. We'll see.
I'm Dr. Casper Darling, and this is my final message. It's not the end. But after this, I won't. I exposed myself to Hedron resonance fully. It is. It's changing me. I see you. Shown so much. Slidescape 36 was where Hedron stopped the spread of another. Oh, it's terrifying. It really is. It's another source of resonance. Trench was exposed to this other. It will now spread. I've done everything I can to stop the Hedron resonance amplifiers. I don't know if it'll make a difference. I won't be here when it happens. I should have told him anymore. I'm being sent one more lesson. Something wonderful, I think.
Upgrade charge. Oh well. But that will be it for today. Next time, let's see how it ends. If it ends. See you later.